also trying to be somewhat creative. We have a music program, and what we may do is commission music for our meetings. So we can commission, I thought we ought to do it with students, you know, students who are trained to be composers, and then would play those, you know, every year or two at our meetings. That's the way we contribute. And right now we have an exhibit it's called Dauntless Courage, and it's on five explorers who were members of the APS. And that includes Elisha Kent Kane, who was from Pennsylvania, actually. And he was an Arctic explorer, and he was on the expeditions to find Franklin. And there's a Kent Fracture Zone in the, a Kane Fracture Zone, rather, in the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. And he did a lot. He did a lot of geographic and other exploration up in the Davis Inlet. Somewhat eccentric guy. And then Audubon was a member. And he did a lot of exploration in this part of the world, in the east of the United States, mostly. Also down south in the west. And Ruth Patrick, who's a contemporary woman, who is a she's a limnologist. Well, actually, she studies estuaries and rivers and studied diatoms. She did a lot of the work on classification and physiology. And then Titian Peale, his father, Charles Wilson Peale, was a founder of the society. It was a patriot of the revolution and a portraitist. He's done millions of portraits, and he named all his kids after, you know, like Rembrandt Peale and Titian Peale. And his daughter also was an artist, and Titian Peale was a kind of an explorer, and was an explorer, and he was a naturalist, and he went on the U.S. exploring expedition, which was after the Lewis and Clark. The feds funded another round the world expedition led by Lieutenant Wilkes, and they circumnavigated the world, brought back a huge collection of natural history and ethnography, and that was the beginning collection of the Smithsonian Institution. So much of the old stuff they had came from that. And Titian Peale did a lot of the paintings. We have a wonderful collection of some of his paintings. Let me see that. Well, we have other contemporary, you know, Admiral Byrd was a member, and Neil Armstrong is a member, and he comes to the meetings occasionally, and I've invited him to chair a program we're going to have next spring on space. So he was the most famous man in the world, you know, for a long time, but by nature, I think, I wouldn't call him shy exactly, but he's not, you know, he's private kind of person. But he has, you know, intellectual and engineering interests, and so I'm very pleased he's going to come to the meeting. So, you know, it's kind of interesting. And I've tried to meet local and our sort of fellow societies in Philadelphia and similar ones. And there's a whole bunch of scholarly and academic and public interest groups in the city. So from time to time, I go and have lunch with them.